Good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 2019 Lilac Ball. I am Ashley Bodkin, a proud member of Prep for Prep Contingent 41. First, I'd like to congratulate Prep's high school class of 2019. I'd also like to extend special congratulations to this evening's honoree, Mr. Paul Taubman. I am honored to stand here before you tonight to share my prep experiences. To be honest, I've had good moments, challenging moments, and a lot of tired, exhausting moments. I'm sure my contingent mates will agree. Initially, I had mixed feelings about prep. I felt excited to make it through all those tests, interviews, recommendations, and writing assignments, and that prep had chosen me out of more than 5,000 other kids. But then, thank you. But then, I felt disappointed that I was sacrificing two perfectly good summers. Summers used to mean trips with my church and singing and dancing classes. Not anymore. I was overwhelmed by the amount of homework. Prep even assigned homework before classes started, an entire novel. And I felt nauseous from the long bus ride to and from East Flatbush as I tried to read and get a head start on my 4 hours of homework. People used to ask my brother if he wanted to be in prep too. My brother? I'd laugh. Nope, my brother was not envious of me and my homework. In just the second week of prep, I looked at all the reading, math, science, and history homework I had and broke down. The workload was a shock to my system. I just kept crying. My mom asked me, "Ashley, why are you crying?" I answered, "It's hard. It's just so hard." Then she began to cry. I know my mom questioned whether she put too much pressure on me by enrolling me in prep, especially since I was already doing well in school. We were both out of sorts and confused. But my mom and I had many long talks. She reminded me that my family and prep were behind me. Little by little, I started to feel better about my prep journey. Early on, prep took us on a trip upstate, otherwise known as Westchester. We bonded over games that only a prep kid could enjoy. Do you remember the game Steal the Bacon? Where you call out a number, and kids from two teams with that number run out to steal the pin? Well, at prep, instead of calling out numbers, they called out complex math problems. We had so much fun that day. I was finally with kids my age who could have fun with math problems. Throughout my prep journey, I kept reminding myself that all of this extra hard work would pay off one day. And along the way, I found more to enjoy about prep. Through prep, I developed a love for reading. We dug deeply into books such as Black Boy and Animal Farm, where we found pieces of our own lives or got lost in different ones. Prep has encouraged us to speak up in class so that our perspectives and ideas could be heard, a skill I know I will carry with me throughout my life. This fall, I will start at Packer Collegiate in the 7th grade. Thank you. All the hard work at prep made it possible for me to attend a school like Packer. When I toured Packer, I felt like I was in Hogwarts. The old brick building, the classrooms with smart boards, and the garden filled with trees made me feel like I was in a different world. The best part was watching the students and teachers interact. Everyone seemed happy to be there. Singing and dancing are two passions that I'm excited to pursue at Packer. When I visited, I loved watching rehearsals for the middle school musical, Seussical. The cast members looked like one big family. I know that by working hard at Packer, I can fulfill my dream of going to medical school. I would like to finish with this quote from former First Lady Michelle Obama. I remember them all, every person who'd ever waved me forward. These were my boosters, my believers, my own personal gospel choir. At Prep for Prep, I have found my boosters, my believers, and my choir. I'm so grateful to God, my mom, Prep for Prep, my favorite teacher, Ms. Irvy, and all of you for launching me forward on this incredible journey. Thank you.